This is Salamancer presented to you in stunning 3D. No, I'm just kidding. Don't sue me. It's not false advertising if I say I'm just kidding. So anyway, Squirrel Clickers versus animals with guns. And he's actually shouting out to a different Sal here because, as you guys may know if you've seen Squirrel Clickers on this channel before, Squirrel Clickers actually have a scout named Sal. Check that over on the right-hand side. Anyway, I was told I had to shoutcast this game. It happened about a week ago. It is Thanksgiving week, and there were no ESEA games this weekend, or the entire week, really, because everybody was going to be out of town, so what's the point in scheduling them, right? But it looks like AWG here getting the first capture on the point. They've got good positioning. Their scouts should probably start trying to finish on... No, I don't know. They probably could have gotten away with one or two cleanup kills there, but may have lost the scouts in the process, so probably a good decision just to stay here. They're all pretty much gathered up on the point right now, and ready to focus fire anybody who shows up. Good spam coming in here too, dealing a lot of damage to these Squirrel Clickers. And guys, I gotta tell you, the names this season in ESEA Open, I don't know what's going on with them. Animals with guns and Squirrel Clickers. You tell me. Anyway, we do have the Squirrel Clickers trying to push forward with Kosa. Both teams have an Uber. Neither one lost a medic. And it looks like Frio was playing the heavy, but he has been taken down there. No Uber for the heavy, which actually would have been really nice for AWG. They didn't get it. So Squirrel Clickers here are going to capture the point now after about 50 seconds taken off for AWG. So already we're seeing a decently matched game. Demoman jumping in here, but Long, the demo, taken out. Now a soldier jumping as well, and he may end up getting... getting finished off here as well. Afro dropping back, and there is no health kit there, but he will be able to get away. Surprised he's not just using the equalizer to rush out of there, but whatever, he didn't. But the Squirrel Clickers hold the point, and now they have a heavy of their own. Let me see where Sleepy's going here. He is hanging around the point right now, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong here, but Sleepy's probably playing a roaming-style soldier, and we will see him do some creative jumping when he thinks the enemy has an Uber or when he thinks he needs to get in there and deal some damage. Right now, he's just dodging rockets, which he's done with some finesse so far. Whoop, that's a little too high. And AWG here lose Frio to some stickies on the point there. That's not going to be good for their chances of recapping right now. They don't even have an Uber yet. They're trying to get in and force, I think, the Uber from Delta Fox, that is, for Squirrel Clickers, but that's not happening right now. Let me see. Nope, they're all gathered up here with a scout not even moving. That's a rare sight, guys. Scout standing still. You can write that one down in your journals today. I saw a scout who wasn't moving. AWG, though, are pushing them forward onto the point now, and this is kind of a weird little trap. Squirrel Clickers giving up most of their ground and actually giving up the point right now. They are rushing forward just in the nick of time to stop the capture. I wonder if that was coordinated. They were just kind of like, yeah, let's draw them into position on the point, but it looks like it's actually working out for AWG. Almost. Oh, maybe not. They haven't captured the point yet, and now they are going to lose their medic here to these scouts. Soldier trying to come in and finish us off. Did he just get Ubersawed? No, I don't think he did. Good try by Delta Fox, though. Maybe, though. He might have. He's at 50% right now, which I think he actually did. Nice, Delta Fox, you're a beast. Somebody's going to correct me on the YouTube comments if I'm wrong anyway, so please do that, because I miss stuff, and it's always good to know. In fact, if you see YouTube comments that are like, Sal, you're an idiot, this is what actually happened, go ahead and like hit the like button on those, so that they'll be the most liked comments, and that way everybody can benefit from your insight, and also, you know, enjoy the creative ways in which you call me an idiot. Squirrel Clicker is losing three players here, so this is the push that AWG needed, but look at the time difference right now, and... just to add insult to injury there, even though they know they're going to lose the point at this point, they're adding a couple of extra seconds here, just five or six extra, and even longer, because nobody from AWG is actually standing on that point right now. Squirrel Clickers were just standing there and blocking that point for such a long time. They've bought themselves an extra 20 seconds from when they should have lost the point there. So 25 seconds left means it doesn't even matter that AWG has a big Uber advantage right now. Squirrel Clickers just have to waltz in there, and at any point... in the next 2 minutes, if they capture, it's almost over. JP here, I like how he spelled that out. It makes me, I don't know, it makes me have to pee myself. But JP here is wandering around, watching the flanks like a good scout should be. And, of course, scouts probing the flanks as well for AWG right now. Animals with guns. Not all of them actually have guns. This guy here has a medi gun, which I'm not sure if that technically counts in the classification... category of guns, taxonomy, I guess, if you will, of our weaponry. But AWG do cap the point, so they're holding on to it. And yeah, like I said, almost over. It's now in overtime. Now if Red Team caps it, it's definitely over. And they look like they're in a good position to do so. They've got an Uber advantage. They're holding their medic pretty far back right now, but they are bombing a soldier forward. That is Sleepy. He's going to go for possibly taking out the enemy medic. He hasn't been able to do that, but he did take out Afro, another soldier. So trading a soldier for a soldier is, it's all right. Frio dropping back behind, but it takes a direct rocket to the face. Should have kind of expected that. He was seen by that other soldier. He just didn't feel like he could go anywhere. And there you go, Squirrel Clickers with round one. 1-0. All right, so going into the second round for Squirrel Clickers versus AWG, I want to see if our Squirrel Clickers, which I can only assume means that instead of computer mice, they have real live squirrels hooked up to a USB port somehow. I want to see if they can continue that streak, because so far they do look like the superior team. AWG has lost their demo man right away, and so I think Squirrel Clickers will end up with this round as well. They are taking just a bit of damage here, but the medic is still okay, and that's what's really important here. Think is at 10 health, and even though he didn't die, you saw what happened there. They lost their demo, then their medic took a lot of damage. And if your medic takes damage, he's going to start running back and looking for cover. Well, if he's looking for cover, he's not able to jump out there and help heal the rest of the team who are trying to be aggressive. So, of course, the rest of the team pretty much has to drop back with the medic. And at that point, you don't have that aggression that you need anymore to push in. Long is trying to set up some stickies right now just to cover that little house, block off any flank routes. And I think AWG may be able to grab the point here. Eating a couple rockets to the face, but they were overhealed. They'll be okay for now. They've just got to be careful they don't start losing that damage advantage. The Uber is popped for both teams, and Sal there, the scout, taking a rocket to the face, but he is getting healed up now. Yeah, it looks like both these teams losing players at roughly even rate. Think needs to start thinking about getting his... you saw what I did there. Getting his players up and aggressive, and right now he's using the crossbow, which is kind of a weird decision on a map like Viaduct, because he is gonna get pressured. Good hit there, and he's going for the Ubersaw, but it's gonna be nasty. Somehow he managed to avoid Sal's scattergun, and he got away with it. So he's gonna hit the cabinet, run back. Not much of an Uber advantage, because he didn't get an Ubersaw off, but at the very least he didn't die and have a big Uber disadvantage, and then his players didn't have any sort of over here at all. But look at the time right now. It is... I've been talking for a minute and almost a minute and 30 seconds with animals with guns not having captured the point. So, what's that tell you? It tells you that Squirrel Clickers are likely to win this round as well. AWG do finally cap the point again, and my ferrets are hissing at each other. But right now, SQC should be able to hop right back up on the point, because they're... Oh, they're taking just a bit of damage from this roaming soldier, but he doesn't get the kill on Delta Fox. In fact, didn't do any damage to the medic, which is probably what he was intending. So now the Uber's ready to go for SQC. It's ready to go for both teams, but this soldier is way out of position, gets taken out by a scout. Meanwhile, he did kill the demo man, Kosa, so that's actually really, really good for AWG, except they've lost two players. Going to be tough for them to get forward. They popped their Uber significantly later, which means they do manage to walk their heavy up onto the point, and they will be able to hold it off for quite a while, bringing the times just a bit closer here. Squirrel Clickers could probably make one more concerted push, but if that one fails, then AWG will be in the lead. I want to see how deep I can go with that. It's Viaduct. We've got time. You kind of wait between pushes for teams to maybe get an Uber until it's towards the end of the round, and then they start making non-Uber pushes, which is more exciting. But hey, you got a heavy standing around here on a rock, wearing a nice little headband, actually. I think he donated to the Japanese Tsunami Relief. I believe that's what those are for. Or maybe he just bought it. I don't know. It's a nice-looking headband. Traded for it. You know what I mean. This soldier is going to get taken out there, and it looks like that was D-Flame who finished off Sleepy. But now Squirrel Clickers has some kills of their own on the board here. D-Flame and Afro getting taken down. It's 3-3, but the thing is, AWG do have an Uber advantage. So the push for Squirrel Clickers did fail. They are now behind on the time. I'm trying to think here. I think halftime in ESEA King of the Hill maps is at 3 points. So we could see a whole 5 rounds go by, possibly, before halftime. Maybe. I mean, that'd be cool. But AWG, I mean, this is a maximum of 7 rounds anyway, so it's not quite half time, is it? You know. But anyway, AWG here, they've got the heavy standing up in front of the dog bread right now, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, Ta-da! Gotta get the... Oh, it's so hard. The camera's too fast. Come on. All right, well, anyway. Uber once again on the point for AWG. That was forced. They probably would have liked to hold onto it. But at the same time, you know, it's going to keep them in a position to hold onto it for a lot longer. They kept their players alive. Got two kills there. Sleepy, Sal, and now Kosa down as well. Smarf running in here. Probably not the wisest decision, as he's going to get knocked out by those two scouts. Delta Fox decides to stay and spawn. That's probably a smart thing to do. I mean, he wants to be building that Uber nonstop, and he is doing so with this scout using that Boston Basher. But now, 10 seconds, this Kritz is not going to be anywhere near ready unless they can cap that point. So, can Squirrel Clickers do it, or will AWG come away with a round? That's the question right now, and it looks like the Squirrel Clickers have gotten two kills so far, but they're having to deal with the Heavy. The Heavy's down, Medic going for kills, it is in overtime right now, and Squirrel Clickers only have one player left, so that's going to be it. Aero Animals with guns take this round back, and I think once they took the point, they didn't give it up. Very nicely done for the Animals with guns. I just rhymed. Again, it's probably a likely thing to happen. I want to say it's statistically probable. With how much I have been talking on YouTube, I have to have rhymed once or twice and not even realized it. Anyway, overheals for the scouts going out to mid. I kind of like that. They are going to be the first responders on the scene. They will be playing kind of the screening role, and then of course you have your soldiers jumping in, hopefully each and one of them with 300 as well, but that's going to be tough to do. Now some sticky bomb damage coming down onto AWG, but it looks like the only man left alive is Delta Fox. He, as well, is using the crossbow on Viaduct. I've talked about that before. I'm not sure I agree with the reasoning, although I don't know the reasoning for sure, but the reasoning for using the crossbow usually is that you get the extra heals at long range, or you can get some extra long range damage. And you're more likely to need the needles on a very enclosed map like Viaduct than the crossbow. If you can see your players on a map like Viaduct, you can pretty much always heal them. So I've never actually seen the crossbow used to heal players, or really even to deal a lot of damage. The Uber is forced here for Squirrel Clickers, not forced yet for AWG, who do hold the point right now. So our red team is looking like they're in some trouble, but the thing is, they did just get two kills here before the Uber was done. Afro, he's not happy about that one. They will take out this Heavy, most likely. There you go. Gets finished off by Long and his sticky bombs. But now Sleepy coming in on top of the Medic. Probably going to take him down. Oh, going to be tough. There you go. Finishes him off with a nice predictive rocket there for where he was going to land. And so Animals with Guns are going to come away with about a minute off the clock, and now it's Squirrel Clicker's turn to try and defend the point. My ferrets are being so mean to each other. They get in this little box, and Sina thinks she's safe, and then Kellner walks in there, and oh, we got a soldier jumping. I should probably pay attention to that. He gets taken out. Well, not taken out yet, but he will. There's not a lot you can do stuck back there, unless nobody pays attention to you, and then Animals with Guns are actually going to cap the point very quickly here. Where is that soldier? Where is he? Where'd he go? I think he got taken out. Yeah, the Heavy probably got him. Aww. Anyway, the ferret's like, Sina will go in this box and she'll think she's safe, and then Kellner will come in and just, you know, bite the back of her neck. She doesn't like it. I don't know why she keeps doing it. You tell me. Animals with Guns, though. Getting up here, and we do have people in stream chat right now telling me that the Heavy is not their favorite class, especially not for Viaduct, because it definitely shuts down a lot of the player's mobility. It makes the game a bit slower. I agree. Like, if I was a player, I would just be like, oh, we have to push a Heavy, that's lame. But at the same time, it's tactically sound. It really is. Having the Heavy out there means that if somebody tries to jump up in the air, he's going to be able to push them all over the place with his big old anti-aircraft gun. He has a big wall of HP that you have to chew through if you want to get out there, and so it's a good choice for defense or offense, as long as you can get him in a position. One nice crossbow shot there on that soldier, but he's not going to finish him off. There's no way. Come on, Think. You should be thinking about your weapon choice right now. He got away from that, so, yeah, it's all right. But Animals with Guns right now are thinking about pushing... I didn't even mean to say think that time, guys. They want to push out. Once again, they have an Uber disadvantage, so they're making a non-Uber push. They're trying their best to keep themselves in the lead on clock time, but it's going to be tough. It's going to be a tall order because they're getting spammed right back through their chokes it's very difficult to make the moves. They all, they're pretty coordinated, though. I like this. They're all calling to rotate around to this side. It's just that they need their scouts watching those flanks so they don't get scouts on top of them. D-Flame actually sitting behind these rocks. I don't think anybody's really realized that he, like, four players pushed forward and three players dropped back. I kind of like that. Yep, Soldier didn't see him at all. He's jumping in, but scout's not really there for him. Going for the medic, but nice air shot there by Frio to take him out. D-Flame now has decided to go in and help defend the medic as well. And let's see what's going on here. It looks like Squirrel Clickers, having lost one player, are now trying to get back here on the point, but it's too late. They didn't manage to stop the capture, so Animals with Guns going to bring it down to another just about even time. A nice kill on Smarf, so the heavy, after that Uber was faded, was focused very quickly and very nicely. He is now dropped. But he's the only player for Squirrel Clickers who is trapped. Animals with Guns doing just about everybody. Afro on the sniper, but he's not able to get any shots off right now, having to drop all the way back to the spawn. So that capture on the point was very short-lived, and now Frio is back on the soldier. So I gotta say, normally on Viaduct we see a lot more sniping, but this time around, neither of these teams, maybe they just don't feel like they have a really super bomber sniper, or maybe they're just more interested in having two soldiers. Having two people able to jump up in the air like that is pretty darn important. Well, we'll find out. It looks like Frio is dead, and Animals with Guns are going to have a tough time pushing as a result. They're taking this choke point once again. You might ask, well, gosh, they just keep getting spammed out of the way they're taking it. Well, it gives you better visibility onto the point in terms of high ground and openness if you can get up past those stairs and past these boxes. So, they probe, they try. But it does look like Animals with Guns are losing this round. They've still got a minute left on the clock. Squirrel Clicker's getting way too many kills here, so D-Flame's on the sniper, but he's not going to be able to push onto that point. And there you go. Squirrel Clickers win the round to bring it to 2-1. Bam. Well, I like to see that. Squirrel Clickers are really, I think, doing just a little bit of a superior job playing most of the time. The last round, they just had some utterly failed pushes, and that is what kind of lost them the round. But this time they've really done a good job of the the ambushes. No, it looks like they're getting out DM'd though in this round, and they are going to have to drop away from the point. AWG will cap it first. They've got better positioning here. They are killing Sleepy, who made a weird decision to just kind of jump in there. Maybe he was going for the medic, but if you go for the medic, I'm making faces at my stream right now. If you go for the medic, you need to know where he is. Because if you just make a jump in, you think you know where he is, and it turns out he's in a different spot, and you miss all your rockets, and you die, then what's the point of jumping in? You're not helping your team that much. And it seems like that's been happening quite a lot. I don't know. Maybe they actually do see them, and they just get, like, popped out of the way on the jumps or something. But it does seem like they're jumping without really knowing where they're jumping, and that can be very dangerous for either team, really. Once again, we do see another one of those weird jumps, and if D-Flame jumps in there as a scout, forces the pop early on the Squirrel Clickers, AWG do respond with their own Uber, and it was, I think, both Demo Men actually got Ubered there. Now you've got a Heavy out here as well, who is overhealed 450 health that our red team has to chew through. They are landing some direct rockets, but it's not enough. I actually saw another crossbow bolt there hit long, but that's not nearly enough. AWG going to put a lot of time on this clock. Already a minute. Sal did get a kill there on Zen, but otherwise, AWG is looking strong right now on the point. They will have just a bit of an Uber advantage, so you know, whatever happens here, unless Squirrel Clickers manage to kill the medic early, maybe Sal will actually get a kill here as the sniper. That's what he wants. But unless they manage to do that, then it's going to be a long time before they recapture that point. Sal looking for the heavy now, and he did get a shot. Two health left on Frio, and he can't finish him off. Oh, nasty. Frio is going to get healed back up, although it's going to take him quite a while. That's a lot of health to heal. And Sal now looking for a headshot once again. Can he get it? Yes, he can. Frio is gone. So Sal already paying for himself here. Animals with Guns have lost three players. They are Ubering just to save some extra time on the point, which is always a good idea. Demo Man here getting taken out, though, and Think needing to drop back. Nope, didn't drop back. Instead, decided to get shot at by JP. And, sounds like Smarf did get taken out by Zen, so at the very least, they got one kill out of that. It was the Heavy. It's not bad. It's going to mean that he's going to respawn a lot later. Animals with Guns don't have to deal with him quite yet, and it could be that he even changes classes. Heavies are tough to deal with, so if you can take him out and make him change classes, it's good. But he didn't. He is still on the Heavy. Let's see. I want to see the Zen cam. I have not watched this guy yet. Zen is just peeking around, playing the passive scout right now. So he will be watching flanks, seeing if he can't find any place to poke in, because if nobody's looking at him, that's when the passive scout becomes active. If nobody really spots him and he sees a little a route that he can take to sneak around the backside, that's what you got to do. But right now, he's just watching these flanks, making sure that nobody comes in towards them, and he will be able to deal that damage once the rest of his team pushes forward. And there you go. He did find a route briefly where nobody was watching, jumped right back out of there. That's pretty much what you do as a scout. You don't have enough health to run in and be the main battle tank like our soldiers here do with that overhealed 300. Somebody was asking if the atomizer is legal, and in ESEA, no, the atomizer is not legal. It is that bat, of course, that gives you a triple jump. I don't think it's legal. The Boston Basher is, though. That's a new addition this season. And it has allowed scouts to build Uber at the maximum rate, which really they couldn't do before because they couldn't damage themselves. Now they can. Animals with guns have not capped the point yet. They do have a big player advantage, and so they should be able to. Seems like Sal's still on the warpath, though, trying to snipe. Gonna get jumped in by a soldier. That's what you like to see roaming soldiers do. Jump, close the distance really fast, so the sniper cannot respond quickly enough, and then just go nail him. So animals with guns capture the point once again, and they are looking in a good position to tie this game up. I do think that AWG I don't want to say surprising me, because I didn't like know for sure the relative strengths of each of these teams, but after the first round, I thought, wow, Squirrel Clippers look really good. And AWG are proving that they are pretty much just as good. SQC, Squirrel Clickers, going to get on the point once again. They will be able to take some time off the clock, and it's still anybody's game right now, because AWG could very well just put together a couple fail pushes, but they've got a big Uber advantage. As long as Think doesn't die, I think they should... I swear, it's the last time I say Think and this guy's name in the same sentence. But they should be able to push forward with this, and that's exactly what they're doing. Frio, trying to launch some rockets there, but he's not quite in the right position to be able to deal all that damage, and Squirrel Clickers only lose Sleepy there. D-Flame getting taken out, now JP as well. So, this soldier, yeah, I think that because Squirrel Clickers right now are surrounded, they're going to have a soldier raining death down upon their medic. That is going to be it for their chances of winning this round. It is going to be 2-2 very quickly here. AWG looking good. They are getting bombed in, actually. They lost quite a few players there. But it's going to go into overtime. So, I mean, they're making the right decision, I think, by dropping back. They've got an Uber advantage. They can just go in there and deal a little bit more. Oh, they got to be careful with this. I do like that scout... Who was that scout there? Was that D-Flame jumping... Yeah, that was, I think. Yes, maybe. Let's find him. Yep, D-Flame jumped right in on the side. That was a really nice play, and I don't know if it was... It probably wasn't coordinated. But what happened there... It is, of course, 2-2. Animals with guns versus Squirrel Clickers. Oh, man. Gonna lose my voice. But what happened there was that there were only three players really available for the battle at the time. It was just Long, Think, and D-Flame. Well, Long and Think pushed forward against, like, four players by themselves and said, okay, well, come at us, bros. And when everybody turned around from Squirrel Clickers and came at them, that's when D-Flame snuck around behind, nailed them. Did a really good job of it, too. So AWG are now getting onto the point here once again. And we'll have, I think, the first capture of the round. There you go. Animals with guns are apparently dangerous. I didn't think they'd know how to operate them. But Squirrel Clickers, I mean, these guys, they're... I'm not even going to try to make the joke I was just about to make, because I would have groaned myself. And that's no good for casting, right? You know, I'd rather cast than groan. But animals with guns... are probably going to lose the point very quickly. They tried to get in there, kill the medic, take out a couple of the players, and it's not working at all. Good scout work here by JP. Took out Long, and now it's going to be just Think left alive. Smurf is looking to see if he can't get that kill, but he's taking a lot of damage too, so where is Think right now? This guy is still inside that house. I wonder if they realize he's in there. I don't think they did. I think they just thought he got away. Nice hiding by Think, who... preserved about a 30% Uber. They still have a disadvantage, but at least he didn't die, right? That would have been even worse. So, he has met up with the rest of his team, who can now keep him protected. And both these teams just kind of skirmishing at the moment. They are not taking a lot of kills, although they are taking a bit of damage. Of course, Sleepy and Frio down at the bottom, they're both looking quite hurt. Frio not getting a lot of the heals that he wants until just now, so... Oh! Can animals with guns push onto the point here, or will the squirrel clickers go up 3-2 and bring it to halftime? Is there even a time limit? I don't think there is. Yeah, AWG forced the pop out of squirrel clickers first. They are popping their own Uber now, and the rest of the players who are not getting the Uber are scattering, which is actually a really good idea. As soon as they collapse back in onto the point, that's when we get to see whether they can actually out-DM their opponents. But AWG, oh, it looks like cannot actually do that. So, oh, they are making that wrong decision once again, pushing forward when they should be dropping back, and they will get their medic safely back into spawn, but might lose this soldier here. He jumps up, goes for a kill on Smarf, and actually nails him. Nice kill by Afro. He did manage to get that health pack and try to attack Delta Fox, but Delta Fox is no slouch. He is, in fact, a fox. I don't even know what kind of animal a slouch is, but he's not that. So, no. Delta Fox is quite good, it seems, at dodging the incoming spam. And he's just not taking a lot of hits this game. There have been a couple times where he's been forced by a scout who just gets in and his soldiers don't realize it. You just can't dodge hit scan weapons, but you can definitely dodge rockets and pills, and he's done quite a nice job of that. Now, the animals with guns hold the point. They have an Uber, so it's going to be tough for squirrel clickers to push in and capture this point. But right now, Afro's actually down, so squirrel clickers have an opportunity. They've got a player advantage. They've got a heavy standing out here. Smarf, once again, playing the heavy weapons guy. And, yeah, they've gotten two kills now. They've lost their demo, which kind of sucks, but that heavy is still out there, still trying to deal damage to invulnerable players, actually. So the Uber was a lot later once again for AWG. They've done some good Uber management in this game. They're stopping that cap for a nice long time. Can it be enough to really keep them in this game, though? No, so far, squirrel clickers, well, yeah, they should be able to cap the point now. There they go. They might lose it right back, because Afro's making a nice big jump there, but doesn't... Well, no. Delta Fox was taken down. Good kill by Afro, and then he craters. Ouch. So, squirrel clickers do hold onto the point temporarily, but they've lost their medic. They've lost the health and the Uber advantage, and even, like, the local player advantage here. There's four players up for blue. There's only two ready to go, really, for squirrel clickers for the next couple of seconds. Yep, there we go. Gotta fix my webcam. You know, it's the joys of being a caster. But squirrel clickers are needing to push forward pretty soon. It's about 20 seconds of... No, 10 seconds of time... No, 20 seconds. I'm stupid. Of time difference right now. And the squirrel clickers need to increase that gap by getting back on the point as quickly as possible. Put them in a good position. Right now, they are making one of those non-Uber pushes we were talking about because they know they have a disadvantage. They need to force the pop out of think. Getting some time on the point, and there you go. The Uber is forced for AWG, but they've gotten three kills out of it. So an effective Uber, I would say so. They haven't killed the medic. So Delta Fox, keeping himself alive, probably a pretty good idea. He will keep the rest of his team alive as well, and hopefully get out there and do the Uber. If I, like, stop talking for a couple seconds, it's probably because I've had an entire bottle of wine over the past 2 days, and that's a lot for me. It was good. It was like this Rhone wine, although I guess it had a lot of, like, preservatives in it because we bought it in America, but yeah, it was pretty good. But Squirrel Clicker's already losing Sleepy there. Afro, though, the heavy weapons guy, was caught out of position, taken out, and Squirrel Clickers with some really good focus fire there. Pretty much their entire team put together. It was a 4v1 there on the point, even though most of animals with guns were alive. Zen was the only one in position to deal any damage or take any damage, and as a result, he took all the damage. But here comes the Uber now for AWG. They should be able to get right back on that point. Long and Frio helping take out Delta Fox. And now the demo's going to die as well. Did a bit of damage, and ooh, Squirrel Clickers have two players up right now, JP and Smarf, who cannot stop AWG from capping. So, the animals with guns looks like they have this round in the bag, and that will bring us to halftime, unless something crazy happens here from our red team, and no, that is the half. So we did see, just briefly there on the screen, you saw that Smarf said GLHFNH, which I assume the NH stands for nice hats. I mean, complimenting your opponent's hats is it's really, really nice, well-mannered. I like this out of these teams. Right now, of course, I actually should be animals with guns in the lead, right? I'm actually going to, like, scroll up and check. Yes, it is 3-2 in favor of AWG, who are in the red now and actually losing a lot of players, although they've gotten a lot of kills as well. Sal is on the sniper right now, and they've got to watch out for this. Think has a Kritzkrieg, probably one of the first if he actually gets this Kritzkrieg off, it'll be one of the first uses of the Kritzkrieg in the game. He goes for the medic. Sal can't get him, though. Now he has to drop back through this house. Ooh. Yeah, he's not going to get chased down too much by this scout and may have another shot here at the medic. But meanwhile, we're going to take a look at Long, because Long ought to be the one taking most of the Kritzkrieg here. Yep, there you go. Kritz is popped. He's got a full rack of stickies loaded up right now, but not able to get a lot of kills. I'm not sure what he was firing at up there on the ridge. It certainly wasn't a medic, though. It looks like the Ubers popped for Squirrel Clickers, so they should be able to get back on the point pretty quickly. AWG have to drop all the way back to spawn, and the Kritzkrieg is not worked out for them so far. They're going to have an advantage with it, hopefully, as long as they can build it nice and fast. But actually, so far, Squirrel Clickers are building their Uber pretty quickly. Sal going for an overheal, but actually doesn't get it, so he's just going to go stand up with an overheal. He doesn't have to worry about an opposing sniper, because Afro has been taken down, so he's going to be okay for a bit. Just wants to make sure he doesn't take too much in the way of rocket spam, which he is right now. Gets the headshot on Frio, though. Good shot by Sal, who will continue scoping in. Not a lot of health on this guy, but he should be able to finish off most of his opponents. And now I've got other people contacting me in the middle of casting, which I can't talk to you while I'm casting, guys. Come on. Here comes that Kritzkrieg once again, and Long finish off there by Sal, so that Kritz is almost entirely useless. A crit rocket there actually slamming into Sleepy, but it didn't kill him, so there's a lot to be said for overheals, and this is of course why Duder hates the quick fix. Squirrel Clickers do have an Uber, and they just now popped it. Looks like Afro's going for the kill on Sal, but now he's getting pressured by some soldiers as well. Oh, it's going to be so nasty for him. He manages to get away from that, but he didn't take out Sal, so Sal is still going to be up there raining down headshot death on AWG. Or I thought he was, but then Afro just found him out anyway. So, you know, change your sniper hides every so often. Otherwise, you might get found out and get a little predictable. It's a lesson of that little encounter. AWG need to capture the point, because they are now a minute behind on the capture time. And it looks like they are going to do just that, but Squirrel Clickers are going to be pretty happy about their positioning right now. Oh, what's going on here? That Kritz was popped at a very weird time. Delta Fox was nowhere to be seen. Did they get any kills with that? What happened? Did Think just accidentally hit his bind for Uber? Ouch. I don't know what happened there. He wasn't forced. Maybe they thought they saw something, but there was nothing there. That is a big waste, because now Squirrel Clickers can actually push in if they realize that happened, which I would think that they did. They have the Uber now and are pushing forward with a heavy. Got his minigun out and just waltzing all the way onto the point. See, this is the thing about a lot of players, as they're new anyway, they'll get Ubered as a heavy and they'll think, oh gosh, I gotta deal damage right now while I'm still invincible. And that's not true. We just saw that heavy use the Uber to just walk onto the point. And that's all he had to do. Oh, Afro looking for the shot. Can't get that medic down. But yeah, that's all that heavy had to do. He just had to walk onto the point. And now that he's in the position to deal damage, it's tough to push back into him. Of course, AWG is doing that just now. They've got the crits and actually did take out JP. Oh, Delta going for a kill there on D-Flame, but D-Flame finishes him off. So AWG hold the point once again. This is a close round here. If AWG win it, of course, they win 4-2. If it's the other way around, then it's going to be 3-3, and that makes for an exciting game. But this has already been an exciting game. We've got a sniper in a really forward position here. Let me see. Afro is just begging for somebody to come out of this this hallway right now. Nobody doing it yet, and he's got to be careful about hiding his sniper dot. Oh, he spots a scout, but that scout was prepared. Definitely prepared. Didn't just run straight out there. And now he's spotted that they do, in fact, have a sniper. Delta Fox running the Kritzkrieg now as well. And it looks like AWG are in the lead on time again, which is pretty darn good for them. They've almost got the Kritzkrieg, and in fact, they do have it. JP taken out by a Crit Sticky, but that may be the only kill, as the rest of the team has dropped mostly back. Soldier coming in on top of the medic, and that is it's actually not a bad decision against most demo men. If you can get right up in their face, right up in their medic's face, sometimes it's really hard to aim those pills and stickies at close range, especially if you've just wasted a whole bunch of stickies and you only have one or two left in your rack. That can be a really, really nice decision. Bomb in right on top of the medic, take him out, finish that Kritzkrieg really early, force the demo man to deal with you instead of trying to chase after your medic. I mean, what a great idea. So, I don't know. I'm just singing this guy's praises right now. But it worked. So, you know, what can you say? Squirrel Clickers are going to try and push forward to hold the point. They do, once again, have that crit squeak. AWG probably have the same thing. I don't think either team is really... I think it did... told myself I wouldn't do that. Think did go down there, but he does still have an uber advantage, so maybe not. But AWG, they gotta make... This is gonna be pretty much their last push here. 20 seconds left on the clock. If they don't cap it now, they aren't gonna cap it at all this round. Can AWG win the match, or will Squirrel Clickers come back and bring it to 3-3? Both soldiers jumping in there simultaneously. And it seems like Frio and Think both getting taken out for AWG. They've lost three players now. Zen trying to help capture the point, but there goes a Kritzkrieg on a scout. Just one shot from that scout will take anything down, just about. Especially a scout. I mean, as long as it's a decent shot. But there you go. It is 3-3. A very good round by both teams. And once again... There. Close enough. I think they call it dog bread, actually. Not pug loaf. I think I called it pug loaf. My bad. It's the dog bread. Regardless, it's now 3-3 AWG versus Squirrel Clickers. And Squirrel Clickers looking like they are the comeback kings at the moment. Even though they had the first round of the game, they did end up going into halftime at a loss. At a deficit. And now they're running the Kritzkrieg once again. I think both teams, actually, considering how even they are, probably are doing that. But Delta Fox gets taken down. Squirrel Clickers losing too many players here. AWG has kept their medic alive. No, he was running the regular medigun. Oh no! Gets taken out by Sal, so crazy brutal action right now. It looks like AWG will probably cap the point, but JP getting up here and reverting all that capture time, so buying a lot of time for his team. Delta Fox still running the Kritzkrieg. Squirrel Clickers have finally lost the point there to AWG. So time is now ticking down on the final round here between Squirrel Clickers and AWG and ESEA Open. And AWG have a big uber disadvantage. Nice air shot by Smurf to take out Frio. So AWG probably they're going to lose that point very quickly and probably can't take it back for quite a while. Squirrel Clicker is going to put some good time on the clock. It's only been 20 seconds since the animals with guns captured the point, and already they have lost it. Delta Fox running that Kritzkrieg. We're just going to keep on the Kosa cam because we know, you know what's going to happen if you've ever seen any of my videos before. Actually, he's making a sticky trap, so he's going to have to reload. It's close. But anyway, they're waiting for the push to come in now, and actually they pop that Kritz just a little bit early, looking for a kill though, and do get D-Flame! But there goes the rest of the Kritzkrieg. Delta Fox was taken down by the jump from Afro. So, once again, does seem to be a tactically sound way of finishing off a Kritzkrieg just a little bit early. JP, though, helping to push back most of the AWG team there. Where is their medic and soldier right now? Looks like they have managed to escape these scouts for the moment. Delta Fox running back to spawn, and animals with guns cannot cap this point right now. They're having some trouble. Squirrel Clickers holding onto it for a full minute already, and now they're having trouble. There you go. Big Zen rushing in and going big. He's managed to get two kills here and to start a good amount of capture time on the point. So helping keep animals with guns in this game is Zen the Scout. And now just kind of playing a more passive role here as he waits for the enemy push to come in or waits for some kind of opportunity for an ambush. That's what these scouts are doing all the time, man. Squirrel Clickers building their uber up to about 70%. Is Delta still running at the Kritzkrieg? It looks like it. So we're going to keep on that Kosa cam once again. He's going to get the crits very, very soon here in the next couple of seconds. And he wants to kind of rotate around this side. Here goes these crit stickies. Can he get the kills? That's the question right now. The crit stickies are taken out long, so no demo at the moment. And there you go. Animals with guns have lost three players. Delta Fox did get taken down, but they've got so many fragging classes up that Squirrel Clickers should be able to capture the point back. And that they will do. It's just D-Flame and Think right now. They're keeping themselves alive, but they can't stop the capture. They didn't have the Uber up in time. And 99% on Think. He will get that up to 100 right now. He's ready to charge. He's fully charged. Whatever it was he just said, it was important because AWG are going to push back out now with an Uber. They just have to watch out for flanking going on against Think, and so far, not a lot of that happening. So they're pushing. Nice push here. They haven't had to pop yet, actually. Squirrel Clickers. Oh, they send a soldier right in behind. That was a nice little ambush. I don't even know where he was hiding from, but Sleepy did force the pop without AWG really being able to deal any sort of damage to Delta Fox. So once again, they're going to have that Kritzkrieg ready to go. AWG need to cap the point. Well, actually, they have. My bad. I keep getting confused. But they are in the red now, so they have captured the point. Kosa waiting for the Kritzkrieg. Now, AWG know this Kritzkrieg is coming. They know it. They should be hiding from it. One good kill already, though. Afro's down, and Squirrel Clickers will be able to push forward with that to take the point, except that Kosa just got finished off by Long. Nice stickies from Long to take him out. Not even sure where that sticky trap was, but it was good. And let's see, Sal here. Can he stop this capture right now? Because that is really the big question. Or can he kill the medic? That might also be the big question. Think has taken a lot of damage, but he stays alive. Animals with guns holding on to the point. This is a close game, guys. Look at those times right now. They are within 4 seconds of each other. So Animals with guns, they want to hold on to this for the next minute and win the game. But can they do it? Squirrel Clickers, are they still running the Quitzkrieg? Yep, they still are. Let's find that Kosa cam again, because they're going to have it. They're going to have a Quitzkrieg, but they're going to have to deal with the full uber of Think. Still no sniper to take him out, so they're going to have to bomb in a soldier or something to force him to pop early. So far not doing that, so they're just going for DM ability at the moment. And Frio's finished off there with no losses for Squirrel Clickers, but they got to get in there and start getting these frags fast, because what matters is time on the point. Here comes the Quitzkrieg right now, and it does force the uber out of the red team. No kills on that Critz. It pretty much was just to get the uber forced, and the animals with guns have about 30 seconds left here to hold this point. Right now they are getting pressured back away, though. There goes the demo medic, probably going to get taken out as well. No, nobody pressuring on after him, which is kind of a weird decision in my opinion, but Squirrel Clickers will cap the point, and they just have to hold it for a minute now. But AWG, if they recapture it, this game's almost over, because it's only 18 seconds left for them. Let's see if they can't make a decent push. Oh, Afro getting taken out by Sleepy. Didn't realize that soldier was there. So already losing one soldier on this push, and it is going to be a heavy medic coming out here for the Squirrel Clickers to help defend the point. Do they have a regular uber now? Hang on. Delta Fox has a regular uber. May not even get a chance to use it, because he's at 25%, and there's only about 15-20 seconds left in the game. Animals with guns get a couple of good kills there, and so they do hold the point now. It's less than 10 seconds till they win it. Can JP and Sleepy stop this this from happening? I don't think so. Sleepy was just finished off, so it looks like the Animals with guns will win the game. GG for AWG against Squirrel Clickers. That was a nail-biter. Thank you guys for watching. Of course, you do need to subscribe at youtube.com/fatmop, F-A-T-M-O-P. That's where all these videos go in glorious high definition. Thanks for watching.